Ben's not here today, but when she gets home, I'm going to have a special holiday treat for her. And to help me make it, I invited the best chef I know to come and help me. It is Creepy Granny!
Hi, John! Hi, everybody! So, you asked me to come over and give you a hand, but what are we making today?
We're going to be making an old holiday favorite. You may have heard about it in the songs, but never actually had it. We're going to make figgy pudding. You know, like in the song, you know, bring us the figgy pudding. Bring us the figgy pudding. Come on, you know the words, Granny. Sing along.
What the heck is figgy pudding?
Well, it's a real thing. I downloaded the top-rated warm, sticky figgy pudding recipe off of the Food Network, and we're gonna cook it up for Ben. You know, so we can see what figgy pudding tastes like, because in the song it sounds like it's pretty good, because they won't leave until they get some. They won't leave until they get some.
Maybe there's a reason that nobody's heard of figgy pudding. Have you ever made figgy pudding before?
No, this is gonna be a first. That's why I invited you over. We got some figs, we got some sugar. It's gonna be yummy. Are we ready to do this?
Would anybody actually watch a video of us making figgy pudding?
Well, let's get started.
We're gonna get like zero views! Anybody even in there?
Okay, Granny, here's the recipe. Let's get started, okay?
Okay! So, what do we gotta do first here? You got all your ingredients set up already, whippersnapper. Alrighty. So, step number one.
Preheat the oven to 350 degrees.
Okay, I see you got that. Good job. Okay, next.
We need to add dates, dried figs, and water to a medium saucepan and bring it to boil over medium heat.
Okie dokie. So how many figs do we need? I would imagine a lot, because it's figgy pudding.
It calls for a half a cup of chopped figs, and we chopped them up right here, all chopped up. And it calls for a cup and a half of chopped dried pitted dates. See them right there? We chopped them all up earlier.
Not a lot of figs in figgy pudding. Why don't they call it datey pudding? Actually, that doesn't sound very good. Alright, and how much water do we need?
2 cups of water.
Okie dokie. Doesn't that look just absolutely yummy?
Well, Granny, we gotta bring it to a boil. Okay, so we have our fig and date mixture in the water at a boil. Now we're supposed to add in 1 teaspoon of baking soda. You got that, Granny?
Yep, okay.
And then we stir that in.
Okie dokie.
And then we're gonna remove this from the heat for 5 minutes.
Good thing, look at that thing bubbling up. Make a mess.
Doesn't that smell good, Creepy Granny?
I don't smell anything. That's quite fizzy. I wasn't expecting it to be so frizzy. All right, what do we got going on over here?
Okay, well, we got some softened butter.
That definitely softened, all right.
And you were grating this dark chocolate.
I was, yes. My hooves got tired grating that chocolate, you know. I had to take...
I gotta sample some of it, Creepy Granny.
Hey, hey, hey! No, no! You put that chocolate down!
Okay.
If you're not gonna grate that chocolate, I don't want you touching it! You got that?
Oh, okay, Creepy Granny.
Alright, now move on to your next step. What are you doing now? That doesn't look like regular old sugar to me.
We need a cup of superfine sugar, quick dissolve superfine sugar.
Uh-huh.
Took me a while to find this in the grocery store.
I bet. I've never even seen it before.
So we're adding that to our butter. So this is just butter and sugar.
Yummy. Those are my 2 favorite things.
Add the eggs and beat well.
Okie dokie.
With a hand mixer, which we have right over here.
Well, aren't you prepared? Add in those eggs. Don't get any shells. I don't want the shells in my teeth.
There we go, Creepy Granny. 2 eggies in the mix.
Alrighty. This stuff has been off the heat for 5 minutes, so I've added it into the blender here. And now I gotta puree this sucker right up.
Alright, let's take a look at it, okay, Creepy Granny?
Alrighty, let's see what we got.
Alright, let's take that off.
Whoa, that's hot stuff. Look at all that in there. It's still a little chunky, but I think it's all right.
I just need to finish grating our chocolate, Granny.
Yeah, my horse got tired. You had to take over. Big, strong man. Hey, I told you!
No, stop it!
I told you!
Stop it! Granny, okay, all right, look, I'm back to work.
Alrighty. Told you.
Okay, so Granny and I have mixed the flour, the self-rising flour, 2.5 cups, into our mixture of our butter and our sugar. Looks like cookie dough right now, doesn't it, Granny?
Yes, it does. There you go, there's the last of the flour.
And then we're supposed to mix in our date and fig mixture into this pot here.
Yeah.
You got it, Creepy Granny?
Yeah, I got it.
Mixing up our figgy pudding here. Now, Granny, we're in the United States where figgy pudding isn't very common at all, except in the We Wish You a Merry Christmas song.
Yeah.
But I don't know if anybody's actually made figgy pudding in years and years and years. Probably even before you were a filly.
Probably, I know I've never had it.
So, but maybe some of our fans outside of the U.S. have had figgy pudding before. Do you think they should leave a comment and let you know?
Yeah, I would like it. I'd like to know if you guys have ever had figgy pudding and whether or not you liked it.
Okay, now we gotta add in our chocolate.
Okay. Whoa, chocolate. Now I'll be very bummed out if this stuff doesn't taste good, because that was an awful lot of chocolate. And I like chocolate.
There's some big pieces in there because the way I was grating it on a cheese grater. They were getting a little close to my thumb and my finger, Granny. I don't have hooves like you.
Yeah, well, I hope you're careful when you're eating your figgy pudding. You don't choke on a big piece of chocolate.
I'm sure it's going to melt in the oven, Granny.
Okay.
How's that looking?
It doesn't look very mixed at the bottom there, Sonny.
Okay, Granny, you still with me?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, we're going to take our yummy-looking mixture here. Definitely looks like pudding, huh?
It does look like pudding now. A little chunky pudding, but it looks like pudding.
And we're going to put it into, well, it calls for a little 1 cup individual servings, but all we have are cupcake trays. So we're going to fill up 12 of these. I'm going to take a spoonful of that, plop it in there. Then these are going to go into the oven for about 20 to 25 minutes at 350 degrees.
Well, you should probably put it in for a little less than 20, 25 minutes because you're putting less batter in a thing, but we can figure that out as we go.
Okay, we'll just keep an eye on it.
Yeah, we'll keep an eye on it. So we're going to put those right in. Well, you're going to put that right in there. My hooves don't work these spoons very well, so it's a good thing you're here to do all this. Well, actually, I wouldn't be doing it if it wasn't for you, so it's a good thing you're doing all this.
What else would you be doing on December 23rd than making figgy pudding with a total stranger?
Well, you know, I have quite a bit of Christmas shopping I still need to do, especially for Creepy Twilight. You know how hard it is to shop for that little thing?
Speaking of Creepy Twilight, are you,
Yes.
I've heard about her Christmas special on Ben's Toy Bin. Are you going to be a part of that?
That one's a little full there. I am going to be part of that. I don't want to spoil anything, but, I think that it is going to be quite the show. You know, there's an awful lot of people put in suggestions for her creepy Christmas ornament decoration thing.
Does Creepy Twilight like figgy pudding?
She's never had it because I've never made it for her. I make creepy pudding.
What's creepy pudding made out of?
Well, it's pudding. And then there's some special ingredients that I am not at liberty to discuss right now.
Sort of like an old family recipe, huh?
Yes. It's much like a Kentucky Fried Chicken with their 11 secret spices and herbs and such. That's a secret. Not allowed to tell anybody outside the family.
Now, do you think these look full enough, or should I top them off a little bit more?
Well, considering you got self-rising flour in there...
You think I should take a little off the top here?
Yeah, some of them look a little full, and you might end up having to cleave in your oven when you're done. No, put that in a new one. Yeah.
Here we are. Our finished figgy puddings are out of the oven.
Well, don't those look like little muffins? Are they supposed to look like muffins?
It doesn't really look like pudding in the traditional sense. You know, you eat it out of the bowl with a spoon.
Yeah.
Do you think we did it wrong, Granny, or we followed the recipe?
I don't know. We'll have to just test it out and see how they taste.
They smell pretty good.
Yeah, they do.
And over here, we got your sauce going. And this is the sauce that the recipe recommended with brown sugar.
Yeah, brown sugar and the heavy whipping cream and all that butter.
So what we're supposed to do is drizzle this over that.
Okay.
And then we top these off with vanilla ice cream.
Yeah, that sounds yummy.
And to top that off, we got whipped cream.
Holy smokes! My teeth are gonna fall out!
I thought you had false teeth.
Well, hey, just because I'm old doesn't mean I have false teeth, you know.
Okay, sorry, Granny, sorry.
Goodness, you need to respect your elders.
Let's put that sauce, a little sauce, on our figgy pudding.
Alrighty, on your spoon.
Okay, creepy Granny, put that sauce on. Fill that right up.
How much am I supposed to use?
I don't know.
That seems like a lot of sauce.
Oh, that should be okay.
Alright, I'll go this one. You want more sauce on that one? They don't look very even.
Yeah, no. I'll take a little bit more on that one.
Let me get you some more here. Hold on. There we go. I think when I cut that one, I cut better.
Let's put a little ice cream on the top of these.
Yeah, make sure I got plenty of ice cream. And where's that whipping cream? I want that whipped cream on mine. Whoop, slide an ice cream. All right.
Okay, Granny, I'm going to put some whipped cream on there for you.
Yummy, yummy.
There we go.
All righty.
And this should be a traditional figgy pudding. Okay, Granny, you ready for the first bite?
I'm ready.
So this is what they were clamoring for in the song We Wish You a Merry Christmas. It's actually pretty good. I had a feeling something filled with figs, dates, chocolate, and like a pound of butter would taste pretty good. Don't you agree, Granny?
I do agree. I think that it really had no chance for failure unless we cooked it wrong. Which, you know, we very well could have done.
We could have. It's more cake-like than pudding-like.
Yeah, I don't know if that's supposed to be like that, but
it's really good.
It is very, very yummy. I'm gonna have some more. I ate all mine. Can I have some more?
We got plenty of it, but we gotta save some for Ben.
Yeah, I suppose she should have some.
Think Creepy Twilight would like some of this? She'd have it for her Christmas special.
She might like it. I mean, it's not sour. She really likes those sour things, but she might like this.
Well, if you're interested in making the Food Network's warm, sticky figgy pudding, this is the first one that comes up on Google if you search sticky figgy pudding recipe or figgy pudding recipe. But there'll be a link down below. Won't there, Creepy Granny?
Well, if you say so, I don't know anything about links or anything. This is this YouTuber's thing that you and Creepy Twilight do. I just show up when you tell me to.
So, Granny, after we made figgy pudding for ourselves, right here.
Yes.
I guess we can understand in the song why they said we won't go till we get some.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't leave until I got some. That stuff is really, really yummy.
I wasn't expecting anything. I was just...
I thought this was going to be gross. I mean, who eats figgy pudding these days? How come this isn't part of a tradition anymore?
I don't know. I thought it was going to be like a guapy, you know, like a porridge like, pudding, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah, like a warm stew. Not a stew. You know what I mean. You know, all gooey and, you know, with like chopped up dates and figs and stuff. Actually, I never really thought there'd be dates in it. It's figgy pudding. There should be more figgy.
We went over this earlier, Granny.
Okay.
Well, I'm glad you could join me today as we made figgy pudding for ourselves. This might be a new Christmas tradition here at Ben's Toy Bin.
Am I invited next year too?
Of course you are, Granny. You're always invited here.
Give me a little sugar.
Merry Christmas.
Hi. I got my new Christmas date here.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Granny, you lost your glasses.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I don't want to date. You're taken. Now bring us some figgy pudding.